Good morning, everyone. It's Jelani. The morning scripture came from Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17. But we'll read this chapter this morning. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, thanking you for yet another morning that you have allowed us to wake up. The showers this morning again to show you that you pour out your blessing even on this earth, the rain that comes down to water the earth and for it to bring forth its fruit. So likewise, we are showered with your blessing, dear Lord, and we ought to bring forth righteous fruit before you by doing those things according to the leading of your Holy Spirit. And we know we are able to do this only by you and through you, Lord Jesus Christ. And this is why when we approach you, we do ask of you that you continue to lead us on the path, the narrow path of righteousness. Continue to instruct us by your righteous word. And I just ask that you let us be, cause us to be obedient, that we may please you with this life whilst we have it. We look for the life to come, but the only clause is that we have to do what you have told us to do in this mortal life so that we can inherit that life to come. And the things that you have told us to do is not grievous. If we look to the nitty-gritty of it, it is not grievous at all. You only have told us to love one another as you have taught us, dear Lord. And if anybody actually looks at it, it's not that deep. You haven't asked us a hard thing to do. Not only that, you have done it all and you will do it all in us if we ask of you. So there is no excuse for any of us. And I appreciate that, dear Lord. And I'm thankful for your mercies, for your love, for your grace that you have shown unto us, your creation. Though we have turned against you in times past, in times present, and in times to come, we have turned against you, but yet still, your love being long-suffering towards us, you have not cast us away thoroughly, but you have made a way through Christ Jesus, through the shedding of your blood, you have made a way for our redemption. And dear Lord, I just want to pray that when we do read these scriptures and hear these words, we are actually acknowledging you, your character, your love, your mercies towards us, your creation. And that this in turn may humble us, that we may look to ourselves as sinners and look to you as the Redeemer and humbly approach you for our salvation. Lord Jesus Christ, as we have this life yet to live, we know that there's tests and trials in store for us. And my prayer for each and every one of us is that you just keep us from falling. Keep us from giving up. Keep us from looking back like Lot's wife. Keep us from sin in its entirety so that we may please you with this life. And we may be examples and ambassadors of you in this world, showing that light to all mankind, including the youth, raising them up, growing them up in the way and the knowledge and the truth of who you are. So them, likewise, from the youth, may serve you with all sincerity. And we pray that when they're of age, they shall never neglect nor reject you. Lead us therefore in spirit and in truth in your word this morning to the glory of God, our heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Alrighty. So Zephaniah chapter 3, I thought to read the whole thing because I haven't read this book in a while. Right, so it says, "Woe to her that is filthy and polluted, to the oppressing city. She obeyed not the voice. She received not correction. She trusted not in the Lord. She drew not near to her God. Her princes within her are roaring lions. Her judges are evening wolves. They gnaw not the bones till the morning. Her prophets are light and treacherous persons. Her priests have polluted the sanctuary. They have done violence to the law. The just Lord is in the midst thereof. He will not do iniquity. Every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. He faileth not, but the unjust knoweth no shame. Amen. I have cut off the nations, their towers are desolate. I made their streets waste, that none passeth by. Their cities are destroyed, so that there is no man, that there is none inhabitant. I said, surely thou wilt fear me, thou wilt receive instruction, so their dwelling should not be cut off. Howsoever I punished them, but they rose early and corrupted all their doings. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them mine indignation, even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. For then will I turn to the people For then will I turn to the people a pure language, that they may call upon the name of the Lord, to serve him with one consent. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants, even the daughters of my dispersed, shall bring mine offering. In that day shalt thou not be ashamed for all thy doings, wherein thou hast transgressed against me. For then I will take away out of the midst of thee them that rejoice in thy pride, and thou shalt no more be haughty because of my holy mountain. I will also leave in the midst of thee an afflicted and poor people, and they shall trust in the name of the Lord. The remnant of Israel shall not do iniquity, nor speak lies, neither shall a deceitful tongue be found in their mouth. For they shall feed and lie down, and none shall make them afraid. Sing, O daughter of Zion, shout, O Israel. Be glad and rejoice with all the heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord hath taken away thy judgments. He hath cast out thine enemy. The King of Israel, even the Lord, is in the midst of thee. Thou shalt not see evil any more. In that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear thou not, and to Zion, let not thine hand be slack. The Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. He will save, he will rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love, he will joy over thee with singing. I will gather them that are sorrowful for the solemn assembly, who are of thee, to whom the reproach of it was a burden. Behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halteth, and gather her that was driven out. And I will get them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. At that time will I bring you again, even in the time that I gather you. For I will make you a name and a praise among all people of the earth, when I turn back your captivity before your eyes, saith the Lord. Amen. I thought to read this chapter this morning because it just shows again how loving and merciful our God is, right? The grace that he has shown us from the beginning is uncomparable, right? It still blows my mind because even when I was reading, like, verse 5, right? That he's in the midst of us. He was in the midst of us from the beginning, right? Even when Adam and Eve decided to disobey God, he was there yet still, and he clothed them with garments of skin. Likewise, he was in the midst of the people. I'm just jumping the gun here. He was in the midst of the people of Israel when they were redeemed from Egypt, right? When he delivered them from the hands of Pharaoh. And when they went against him many times in the wilderness, he was yet still in their midst, right? And even here in verse 5, it shows that the Lord is in the midst thereof. He will not do iniquity, right? And it show again, every morning doth he bring his judgment to light. He faileth not, but the unjust knoweth no shame. And then look how I think, where's the verse? Verse 7, to show us people his creation. He said, surely thou wilt fear me, thou wilt receive instruction, so their dwelling should not be cut off, right? Howsoever, I punished them, but they rose early and corrupted all their doings. Showing again, the Lord bringing his, every morning it bringing his judgment to light, but yet still his creation every morning, they getting up early and corrupted their doings, right? Just not seeping in his correction. This has been the story right throughout the scripture, if you look at it, right? People going against God, God showing his mercy, he's punishing them, because I believe in punishment, right? And then they repent for a while and then fall back into the same iniquities. And it's not something that I read with joy, because I can imagine like what we do to our Heavenly Father each and every day as his creation, as in he created us for his pleasure, but he takes no pleasure in ungodliness, but yet still, because he loves us, he doesn't just utterly consume us with his wrath and his jealousy in a moment, because he could do it. Don't get me wrong, he could do it. Like, he could just, and then everything passeth away, but his love for us is shown in that we are yet still here, right? Trust me, if God did take me down in my iniquity mode, that I'll be gone ages ago, right? But I'm here today to give him thanks for his grace, for his mercy. So all of us as believers in him and who have faith in him through Christ Jesus can give him thanks, because we are here yet still, right? And verse 17, I like verse 15 actually. The Lord hath taken away thy judgments, showing again his mercy and his grace and his love. I'm reading this and it really just blows my mind, you know, because trust me. All right. Yeah, the Lord hath taken away thy judgments. He hath cast out thine enemy, the King of Israel, even the Lord is in the midst of thee. Thou shalt not see evil anymore. Again, I'm just showing again, he's in the midst of us and his mercies endureth forever. It's mind-blowing. And then verse 17, which was the verse for this morning, just sums up and says, the Lord thy God is in the midst of thee. Sorry, the Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. He will save. He will rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love. Amen. He will joy over thee with singing. Amen. And I'm going to leave it at that this morning. Again, just wanted to remind us, from back in the day, right, that God still are showing mercies and his love to all his creation. And we likewise can learn from these words. We don't want to bring him to jealousy, right? So I'll leave it at that. Share as always what you want in the comments, or in or you can send it in to the word at eachreachone.org. As much as the Lord has led me, taught me, and kept me over the years, I will answer them according to his word, according to his principles, according to his will, being led by his Holy Spirit. Have a blessed day, everyone. And if God's willing, we'll catch up again tomorrow.